I'm going to be comparing these two budget gaming monitors to see how they perform for ghosting and what it means for gaming and productivity. This is the ViewSonic VX3268 2K PC MHD, and it's a VA monitor. It costs $355 USD and has the worst ghosting I've ever seen. Beside it is the ViewSonic VX2705 2KP MHD, and it's an IPS monitor that costs $314 USD. Hardware Unboxed has reviewed this, and it's one of the slowest IPS monitors they've tested, by a huge margin. But first, we have to understand what causes ghosting, and to do that, we have to zoom in. Like, really zoom in. This is a pixel, and it's made out of three subpixels, red, green, and blue. Each of these subpixels can go from zero or off to 100% or fully on. And how long it takes to transition from one brightness to another will determine how much ghosting actually occurs. In other words, the slower the transition, the more noticeable the ghosting. This is what it looks like on a graph. Here, blue has a slower response time or transition time than red because it doesn't reach the desired value as quickly. Now that we know what causes ghosting, let's take a closer look at the two monitors. On paper, they both have a 3-millisecond gray-to-gray response time and a 1-millisecond motion picture response time. These numbers don't actually mean much because in reality, the IPS panel has a 17-millisecond response time. Let's start with the UFO tests. The VA produces much longer trails compared to the IPS. This is only true for the two darker backgrounds though. Looking at the light background, both trails are about the same in length, so there's no difference here. In real life, this means there will be ghosting in darker scenes. For games like Horizon 5, there's already a lot of motion blur, so ghosting isn't very noticeable. Even in areas where there's a lot of high contrast, I wasn't able to see much difference between the two. For fast-paced games like Halo Infinite, the ghosting can also be mistaken for motion blur. I didn't notice any issues when trying to lock onto enemies. Another game I tried is Age of Empires, and ghosting isn't too bad here either. I only noticed it when I was looking for it, and it's more visible along the edges of the fog of war. Now, one game where ghosting is extremely noticeable is Hades. Here, thin lines on the VA panel disappear when I'm moving and reappear when I stop. This is more clearly illustrated along the pillars. The IPS panel performs much better. The lines become dim, but don't completely disappear from view. Another area is the repeating patterns along the handrail. Here, both monitors turn dim, but the VA panel is just a bit more dim before settling to the correct brightness. This is extremely distracting and takes away from the gameplay. So in high contrast games that don't use a lot of motion blur, IPS is better than VA. For productivity, I did notice a bit of ghosting on the VA panel, but it's not very obvious. But to really show ghosting, here's a black background with white text. The text on the VA panel becomes dim before settling to the correct brightness. The IPS is better here and doesn't become as dim. Now to really drive the point home, here's some orange text with a black background. I find these results to be quite fascinating because the on-paper specs are about the same, but the IPS panel is able to perform much better at ghosting than the VA. As for coding, ghosting can be an issue if smooth scrolling is enabled. Typically, editors don't have this enabled by default. What's more, backgrounds are typically not 100% black, and text isn't 100% white, so it's really not an issue. So far, I've shown what causes ghosting and how it affects real-life usage. But there's one additional response time setting called ultra fast. Running the same white on black test on the VA panel, there's no longer any ghosting, and it's the same for the IPS. Going back to the monitor charts, we also see that the response time have decreased from 17 millisecond average down to 6.3. The fastest response time is 1.7 milliseconds. This isn't as fast as the advertised spec of 1 millisecond, but it's pretty close. Numbers aside, this setting seems to have completely solved ghosting. So what's going on? Well, you see, although this setting is able to boost the pixel transition speed, it also introduces something called overshoot. This means colors will first hit a brighter level before settling back down to the desired value. Going back to the graph, this is what the ultra-fast response time looks like. If I wanted to go from 0 to 50% brightness, the pixel might overshoot to 75% before settling back down to 50%. In advanced mode, the pixel never goes above the desired brightness, but takes longer to settle. The 1.7 millisecond measurement is taken when the brightness first hits the desired value, in this case, 50% brightness. It doesn't take into account the additional settling time before reaching the desired value. This can also be seen from the charts from Hardware Unboxed, where the response time is much shorter than the total response time. So how do these charts and graphs correspond to the real world? Well, visually, overshoot causes a glow or inverse ghosting around moving objects. Here, the UFO test clearly shows this effect. There's a white glow around the UFO as it moves across the screen. The issue seems to be much worse with the two lighter backgrounds compared to the darker background. Here's a side-by-side comparison to the advanced setting. I recommend pausing the video here to take a closer look at the images. Compared to the IPS, the overshoot trails are brighter and last longer. Now going back to the original question, the reason why there's no glow is because the monitor can't get brighter than white. In a way, this setting completely bypasses the purpose of this test. But the moment I throw in something other than pure white, then the effect becomes quite obvious. Here, I have ultra-fast response time on the left and advanced on the right. As expected, the ultra-fast overshoots causing the orange text to become brighter. The IPS panel is guilty of this too, and performed just as bad. Testing the ultra-fast setting in gaming produces some really weird results. In Horizon 5, the entire scene lights up and makes the gameplay look a lot worse than ghosting. The best example of this is this telephone line. It's not supposed to turn white. Looking around other scenery, the roads and all the environment elements have the same halo effect. The same is true for the IPS panel to a lesser degree, but it's still very distracting. Trying out halo, we can see the effect very clearly on this rock. This kind of performance is unacceptable for either monitor, so there's no real winner here. In general, ultra-fast response time is not a solution for ghosting and can only be used as marketing material. Now, there's one more response time setting, and that's standard. This is basically the same as advanced, but a bit slower. I wasn't able to tell any difference, and the response time charts from Hardware Unboxed show the same conclusions. So far, I've shown the real-world effects of using advanced and ultra-fast response times. But before putting this experiment to rest, I wanted to test one more IPS gaming monitor. This is the QNX QX2710, and it was very popular back in 2013. This monitor is considered B-stock, which means it didn't pass QA. It has a minimum response time of 8 milliseconds with an average response time of 12 milliseconds. This is 8 times slower than the advertised response times of either ViewSonic monitors. Firing up the UFO test, it performs better than the VA panel. And seeing this really upsets me because it means manufacturers can't be trusted to provide accurate specs. Overall, the ViewSonic VX2705 2KP MHD is one of the slowest IPS panels, yet still has better ghosting performance than the ViewSonic VX3268 2KPC MHD. If you are in the market for a budget gaming monitor, I recommend getting an IPS panel. I've linked a few good ones in the description below. The custom web pages I've used for testing is also there as well. Personally, I find the ViewSonic IPS panel to work very well as a secondary display. The point of these tests isn't to throw shade at VA panels. It's to help you make an informed decision about buying monitors. These things are expensive, and it's hard to make a purchase when manufacturers don't provide accurate specs. And if you're curious about how high-end IPS monitors compare to high-end VA panels, check out this other video that I made. Alright, thanks for watching, like and subscribe. Trying out Halo, we can see this effect very— aw, come on, man.